We have studied directions in our lower classes, right? So we know that how does direction help us? It helps to locate the unknown places. If you want to go to an unknown place, you are not aware of the place, right? So how will you reach to the place? By following the directions, right? For example, you have to reach to your friend's house and you don't know the place. It's a new place for you. You are going for the first time. So how will you go? Or how will you reach? You'll use the directions given by your friend, right? So the directions help us to locate unknown places, especially if you have a map and you have to reach to an unknown place or go to an unknown place. You can locate the unknown place on the map by using the directions. So we have studied the four main directions. What are the four main directions? The four main directions are north, south, east and west. Now these four directions, they are known as the cardinal directions. Okay, they are the four main directions which are also known as cardinal directions. The north, south, east and west are known as the cardinal directions. Now the cardinal directions are further divided into four intermediate directions. Okay, four directions we know: north, south, east and west. They are the cardinal directions. Now these are further divided into four. Okay, they are known as intermediate. And how do we name them? We name them as northeast, northwest, southeast and southwest. So northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest, these four are the intermediate directions. See here? Can you see here? See. The four directions, the cardinal directions: north, south, east and west. Then they are further divided into northeast, northwest, southeast and southwest, which are known as the intermediate directions. Okay. Now in a map, you'll always see an arrow pointing north. See here in this map. Can you see in the map there? Look here. So this is north pointing. See the arrow, and this is N. N is written here. Okay. Can you see the N written there? Yes. So what do you mean by that? When an arrow is pointing towards north, that means that part of the map is north. Okay. That part of the map is north. And once you know the north direction, the other directions are easy to follow. Okay. This helps us to find the other directions as well. So this is how the map has an arrow which points towards the north, which shows us that which part of map is north. Once we know the north part of the map, then the other directions are easily findable. Okay, see here. Now this is an instrument which is known as a compass. Okay, so what is a compass? Earlier when the people or the scientist or people, those who were traveling, travelers, sailors, they were not aware of the directions. Okay, so what they used? They used this instrument which is known as a compass, which had a magnetic needle. And the characteristic of this is that needle always points towards the north. Okay, so when the needle pointed, so they understood that this is the north direction, and then based on that they determined the other directions. Okay, hence, because of this reason, all the maps have an arrow pointing towards the north, and that shows which part of map is north.